Here with acting captain for Kalamunda, Jonh Armstrong. Jonh, that was a massive win today.
Yeah, it was. It was a great win. Boys were impressive from the start. Once we got the jump, we just kept going. It's a good win.
Your performance yourself, I thought was pretty impressive. And through the middle as well, your coach mentioned during the break, so he was really impressed with your ability to break the lines and find space.
Yeah, mate, I'm not about that. All about the team. So the back line, the runoff was perfect, and fours got the job done, and midfield led by Attridge was just awesome.
Yeah, he was a standout today. Has he had a good season?
Yeah, oh yeah. Love having him here at Kala. He's a massive asset. Dominates the midfield. You just see his work rate is just second to none, so he's good to have.
Obviously, Steve Bongiovanni's still got a couple of weeks to go. How did you find yourself skippering the side today?
Between myself and Brett Van Groningen, we week in, week out, the two vice. Nothing different to me, really. I just talk a fair bit on the field, so you know how it is. So, no different captaining.
Well, congratulations on the win. Keeps your finals hope still alive?
Yeah, it does. We need a win next week and just keep winning and hopefully sneak into the five, and I think we could be a threat because the competition, very close.
Well done.
Thank you, mate.
Thanks, mate.
Thank Cheers.
You. Okay, we're here with the captain of Swan Athletic, Ben Kerr. Ben, not a good day for the home side.
Nah, it's a tough day, mate. Kalamunda outplayed us and outworked us, and a few hard truths being told inside at the moment, but we've got to stick together and concentrate in the next part of the season, I suppose, and yeah.
You appeared to have plenty of the ball. In fact, at times you took it up to Kalamunda, but you just fell down going forward.
Yeah.
Almost at times like you were rushing your kicks.
Yeah.
What did Josh have to say at halftime?
Well, spot on. He identified that pretty early, and then I think that stems from probably a lack of voice coming from behind the ball, and us inside probably rushing it on the boot instead of trying to draw and carry the ball. And that's what Kalamunda did so well. They sat behind the play and drew us into the contest, and then they whisked it away out of defence. So, it's something we've been trying to get better at, but the voice isn't coming easy to us at the moment. So, yeah.
You've got to take some positives out of every contest you have.
Yep.
I thought Atchison's game was pretty good. He kicked a couple of goals, and he was calling his name regularly throughout the game. How did you see his performance?
Yeah, Atchie, he's a really hard worker. He's hard in at the contest, and he always gives 100%, and he's one who actually gives a lot of voice. So he's been good for us since he's come back from Claremont, and he's good to have around the joint. So yeah, it's good to see him go well.
Obviously, it's going to be a tough run home the rest of the season. We've got about six odd games to go. What is the focus for the side, given where you are?
Just to get something really out of the rest of the year. You know, we still got a very young side. I think I'm one of the oldest, and I'm 28. So keep the group together. You know, work on things at training, and just I suppose start to think about maybe developing some young guys. But just got to get back to what made us good last year, and that was good team football. We've gone away from that, and that'll be the focus, I think.
Well, not the result you wanted today, but you are a great club and a great bunch of lads, so I wish you the best for the rest of the season.
Thanks, mate. Cheers.
Thanks, mate.